Good day, dear children. Hope all of you are fine. Today I am here with the last and the fourth audio file of the lesson Rat Trap. While going through the lesson, if you have any doubts, feel free to contact your teacher. The last class we've seen how Edla plays an important role in bringing the Rat Trap seller home. And we also find that the Iron Master realizes his mistake. It was a mistaken identity. Or you can say that it was not his old acquaintance as he had thought. And he gets angry, but his anger is lightened by the speech of the rat trap seller regarding the world as a big rat trap. And here you find again Edla intervenes and persuades his father to allow this rat trap seller to have at least one day of peace in their house. Okay, we continue. After that, Christmas Eve at Ramstow passed just as it always had. The stranger did not cause any trouble because he did nothing but sleep. The whole forenoon he lay on the sofa in one of the guest rooms and slept at one stretch. At noon they woke him up so that he could have his share of the good Christmas fare. But after that he slept again. It seemed as though for many years he had not been able to sleep as quietly and safely as here at Ramstow. So you find the poor rat trap seller is having a nice time in the manor house. He is doing nothing but sleeping. He slept as if he had not slept like this in his lifetime. In the evening, when the Christmas tree was lighted, they woke him up again. And he stood for a while in the drawing room, blinking as though the candlelight hurt him. But after that, he disappeared again. 2 hours later, he was aroused once more. He then had to go down into the dining room and eat the Christmas fish and porridge. As soon as they got from the table, he went around to each one present and said thank you and good night. But when he came to the young girl, she gave him to understand, she told him that it was her father's intention that the suit which he wore was to be her Christmas present. He did not have to return it. And if he wanted to spend next Christmas Eve in a place where he could rest in peace and be sure that no evil would befall him, he would be welcomed back again. The rat trap seller gets Christmas presents here. One is the suit and the second one is the offer to spend next Christmas Eve also in the same place. The man with the rat traps did not answer anything to this. He only stared at the young girl in boundless amazement. He could not answer a single word to Edla. He just stared at her in amazement. He was totally surprised the way this girl treated him. The next morning, the Iron Master and his daughter got up in good season to go to the early Christmas service. Their guest was still asleep and they did not disturb him. When at about 10 o'clock they drove back from the church, the young girl sat and hung her head even more dejectedly than usual. At church she had learnt that one of the old crofters of the ironworks had been robbed by a man who went around selling rat traps. "Yes, that was a fine fellow you let into the house," said her father. "I only wonder how many silver spoons are left in the cupboard by this time." So both the Iron Master and his daughter had come to know that a rat trap seller had stolen money from the old crofter. They realized that he was the same man whom they had over as a guest. So the Iron Master finds fault with Edla. The wagon had hardly stopped at the front steps when the Iron Master asked the valet whether the stranger was still there. He added that he had heard at church that the man was a thief. The valet answered that the fellow had gone and that he had not taken anything with him at all. On the contrary, he had left behind a little package which Miss Wilmenson was to be kind enough to accept as a Christmas present. The young girl opened the package, which was so badly done up that the contents came into view at once. She gave a little cry of joy. She found a small rat trap, and in it lay 3 wrinkled 10-kroner notes. But that was not all. In the rat trap lay also a letter written in large, jagged characters. So Edla is surprised to get a gift or a Christmas present from the rat trap peddler. She opened the gift, which was roughly packed. Inside it was 3 kroner notes, a letter and a rat trap. The peddler had thanked his host, who had taken care of him as if he was a real captain. "Honored and noble miss, since you've been so nice to me all day long, as if I was a captain, I want to be nice to you. In return, as if I was a real captain, for I do not want you to be embarrassed at this Christmas season by a thief. But you can give back the money to the old man on the roadside, who has the money pouch hanging on the window frame as a bait for poor wanderers. The rat trap is a Christmas present from a rat who would have been caught in this world's rat trap if he had not been raised to captain, because in that way he got power to clear himself. Written with friendship and high regard, Captain Fawn Starley." So the rat trap seller also added that it was she, that is Edla, who let him free from the rat trap by raising him to the status of a captain. So he was initially a mere peddler. Now he's been raised to the level of a captain. So he thanks her. So that's the end of the lesson. Thank you.